Hey guys, it's Miki Asamar here, and today I'm going to be reading a Tsukishima Kei ex-listener. This one is titled Speak, and this is part 3 in the Soulmate AU. This is a Soulmate AU where, oh, you are deaf, by the way, I forgot to mention that. This is a Soulmate AU where the first words you hear your soulmate say to you are inked onto your wrist. So without further ado, let's get right on into the video. People laugh at the way I talk. That would be the first thing his soulmate would say to him, and he read those words over and over again. He wondered what kind of person his soulmate would turn out to be. Walking into class, he got sight of his best friend and a particular girl in their seats beside each other, with smiles on both of their faces. With headphones on, he ignored them and walked over to his seat in the corner and sat down, pulling out his books for that lesson. "Good morning, Tsuki." He turned to tell his freckled best friend to shut up, as he usually did. But when he saw the smile on Wayne's face and the way that she gave him a little wave, he looked back down at his books and meted them with a short morning. Peering over his textbooks, he saw Yamaguchi reading something that she wrote on her little notebook that she always carried around, before laughing and saying something to her again. He would never admit it, but seeing Yamaguchi have such a good relationship with Wayan made a spark of jealousy spark within him. Even though she was deaf, Wayan never spoke and was efficient at lip-reading and always wrote down her comments in a notebook or phone, making it easier to communicate with her. She was also always appeared cheerful and happy, but Tsukishima could see that she was actually very self-conscious from the way that she would try to cover her face with her hair, and how shy she was to stay away from big groups of people. He admired her for being so strong. It didn't take long for him to develop feelings for Ryan, and the many times he did try to confess to her, but whenever he got her attention, the words he had practiced many times in front of the mirror had disappeared from his brain, and he would end up saying some sort of snide remark. Luckily for him, Wayan quickly got used to those snarky remarks and often wrote down her own sassy retorts. He would often find himself staring at her, waiting patiently while she wrote on her notebook, and marvel in her pretty handwriting as she would shove a small book onto his face. Sometimes, the way she stared at him to read the words on his lips made him blush, and whenever she smiled, that sight alone was enough to send his heart soaring. Time skip. Tsukishima, Yamaguchi, and Wayan were having lunch in their classroom, and the boys were telling her about volleyball practice, filling her in with all the hilarious stories of the barbarian and of the king on the team. The laughter that left her lips made everyone around her stare at her with wide eyes. Almost immediately, whispers started to spread. "I didn't know she had a voice. Isn't Wayan deaf? Do you think she'll be able to speak?" Feeling the piercing stares, she shifted and lowered her head, focusing her gaze on the bento in front of her. Whatever they had to say, she didn't want to know. And from the corner of her eye, she saw Yamaguchi stand up, a deep-knitted frown on his face as he shouted at that group of people gossiping a couple tables away. Tsukishima exuded a menacing aura as he glared at them, almost daring them to speak up. They were receiving more and more attention, and not being able to handle all the questioning looks, Wayan dashed out of the classroom, tears welling up in her eyes. Time skip. Tsukishima found her on the roof, hugging her legs close to her body as she rested her chin on her knees. Slowly approaching her, his chest clenched at the sight of seeing her with such a sad expression on her face. Making sure that she had seen him coming, he sat down in front of her. He waited for her to look at him before saying, "Are you alright?" She nodded, wiping the wetness from her face, sniffling as she did so. "Yamaguchi and I made sure they won't say anything again. He was really worried when he ran off." Watching her closely, he added, "And I was worried too, you know." Mustering a small smile, Wayan wanted to give him a reply, but when she realized both her phone and her notebook was still in the classroom. Knowing what she was looking for, Tsukishima took out his phone and passed it to her, waiting as she typed out a message. "Thank you for standing up for me, Kei. But there's really no point in that. They'll always think of me as a freak." "How could you say that?" He frowned after reading what she had typed, and she could see the intensity building up in those golden eyes of his. "It must be true. I don't even have a soulmate." She rolled up her sleeve on the uniform and showed her wrist. Blank. There was no letters inked onto her skin, unlike the black words written onto his. For once, Tsukishima was at loss for words, and could only watch as she looked away from him, blankly staring at the sky. Had she always felt like this? As if she would be alone with no one out there waiting for her? It was impossible. Everyone had a soulmate. He had wrecked his brain for all sorts of possibilities, and when he thought about the words on his own wrist, something in his head clicked. His infatuation with her, the strong urge to protect her, the desire to hold her when she looked so upset. Everything would make sense if his theory was correct. Tsukishima tapped her arm to gain her attention before asking her, careful of the words that he used. "Don't mind me asking, but is it true that you can speak, right?" She nodded her head as he pressed on. "Then why don't you?" She stared at him as if she was trying to tell if he was joking, but when she realized the way he was asking was completely sincere, she sighed and mumbled quietly, "People laugh at the way I talk." His breath was caught in his throat and his eyes widened. Her words were a tad monotonous and drawled out, but her voice was nevertheless melancholic to his ears. And her words made his heart skip a beat. Those were words he saw every day, and now someone had finally said it to him. Thinking he was judging the way she spoke, her facial expression fell and bit her lip, shifting uncomfortably. "Wayan, you're my soulmate." A blush creeped up onto his face as he showed his wrist, watching her expression turn into one of surprise. "I think," he explained, looking at her. "It's not the first words our soulmates say that get written on a wrist. It's the first thing we hear from them. That's why you don't have any words on you." "We're soulmates?" she asked, a hopeful smile lighting up her face when he nodded, embarrassment filling his features. Trying his best not to spoil the moment, he told her, "You should talk more often. There's nothing wrong with the way you speak, and I won't let anyone make fun of you, so please don't cry anymore." Despite herself, Wayan started to tear up at the words. For the first time in years, she didn't feel so alone. That was so cute. Oh my god. I love Tsukishima so much. The way he's so like... Sorry, I need to stop like... doing that. I really hope you guys enjoyed. If you heard a little bit of background noise at the end, because my fucking dog's walking around, like my fucking ceiling is made of like paper, because if he walks around you can hear it and it's really annoying. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that, because I really enjoyed reading that one. That was so sweet. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure you tap the subscribe button and like the video, because it is something for the YouTube algorithm, as well as tapping the notification bell so you get notified when I post new videos. Woo! Because I do that. I try to post every day. And if I don't, I am sorry, and I usually post another 2 videos the next day just to make sure that you guys get your content filled for the day. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you comment down below some other characters you want me to read, because I definitely do requests. I will be posting a Kenwa one. Actually, no, I posted the Ken one before this. I forgot. I haven't edited any of those videos yet. That's why I'm saying that. The Ken one video should be before this, because this is part 3. So, the next video I want to do is the Cotton Candy Kiss Oikawa ex-listener, because I haven't done that one yet, and I've been waiting to do that, so I'll probably do that one next. Anyways, thank you guys so much for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye!